Centreville School Reunion. In August 1993 at the Fire Hall in Sandy Cove, Nova Scotia. Centreville, of course, a little farther up the neck toward Digby. And people are beginning to gather for the afternoon and evening's activities. What's that, Patsy?
We'll all get a copy of the video.
If you like.
Would it be nice?
Sure. That was Patsy Morehouse Merritt.
Some people you just don't put.
It's not on, Cookie. It's not on.
No, I know.
No, no. It's only on when the red light's on.
Yeah. I want to talk to you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Enterprise.
And we all
part of the program today, and I'm really honored to do that. I went to the Centreville School for about a month in grade 4, and then about a month in grade 5, and that counted for this reunion. I'm pleased about that. She asked me to sing a song, and usually when I sing here, it's because somebody died. I've sung at several funerals, none of yours. And I just soon not sing at yours, but there is a song that I've never sung at a funeral. The mic doesn't work very well with this song, that's why I'm not using a microphone. So if you're having a little trouble hearing me, then I apologize for that. Somewhere along about 1948 or 49, in the summertime, I think it was the summertime, there was a country and western group that put on a show in the hall in St. Joe. Now, I don't know if any of you remember that group that came through, but in the process of the program, the group sang a song. It's the only time that I've ever heard that song, and I remembered most of the words. And I tease my family with the song every once in a while, and somebody overheard it and said, that's the one you need to sing in the reunion. And the title of it is the Chocolate Ice Cream Cone. Now, Dorothy remembered slightly different words to this, and if you remember different words, in my apologies in your version, but this was the version that I remembered that country western group singing in the same show hall, okay? If I get the right key, then I'm in good shape. If I get it too low or too high, I've got to go all the way through. I may start and stop 2 or 3 times, so you'll forgive me if I do that. My mommy said if I'd be good, she'd send me to the store. She said she'd make some gingerbread if I would sweep the floor. She said if I would make the beds and watch the telephone. She said she'd send me out to get a chocolate ice cream cone. And so I did the thing she said, and then she made... Why is it that my singing got you quiet and nothing...
It sounds good.
No. I think it was such a shock. It ain't the pearly gates or whatever that is. I need to start back two ways. She said if I would make the beds and watch the telephone, she said she'd send me out to get a chocolate ice cream cone. And so I did the thing she said. And then she made the gingerbread. Bonnie knows this one. You know this?
Go ahead.
And then she made the gingerbread. And I went out, just me alone, and got my chocolate ice cream cone. There's more. On my way home, I stubbed my toe upon a mean old stone. And when I did, it made me drop my chocolate ice cream cone. A little doggy came along and took a great big lick. And so I hit that mean old dog with just a little stick. And he bit me where I sit down. And he chased me all over town. And now I'm lost, can't find my home. And all because of chocolate ice cream cone. And now I'm lost, can't find my home. And all because...
was composed by Dorothy Shaw Greenan. And it's called The Little Old School at Centreville. The little old schoolhouse has been gone many a year, and for some it brings a tear of memories good and some that are bad, a big part and a small part was all that it had. You started out in the small part and graduated to the big if you were smart. We had 2 toilets where we could go in all kinds of weather, even the snow. The boys had their own, and the girls did too. We would raise our hands when we had to go. We had to walk to school in deep snow, sometimes through the field, did you know? In the winter, we took our lunch in a pail, but in the summer, we would walk home without fail. And the old-fashioned stove gave us some heat. When it was real cold, that's where we would meet. So that's how we learned our ABCs and tried hard the teacher to please. The teachers all did their best, and it was up to all of us to do the rest.
Okay, we were born before penicillin, before polio shots, frozen food, Xerox, plastic contact lenses, frisbees, laser beams, and ballpoint pens. Before pantyhose, dishwashers, clothes dryers, electric blankets, air conditioners, microwave ovens, drip-dry clothes, Pampers, and before man walked on the moon. We still had inches, miles, quarts, and gallons. We got married first and then lived together. Bunnies were small rabbits, and rabbits were not Volkswagens. Designer jeans were skinny girls named Jean, and having a meaningful relationship meant getting along with our cousins. We thought fast food was what you ate during Lent. We were before house husbands and Mr. Moms, computer dating, dual careers, and computer marriages. We were before daycare centers and group therapy. We never heard of CDs, tape decks, electronic typewriters, artificial hearts, word processors, yogurt, and guys wearing earrings. For us, time sharing meant togetherness, not computers and condominiums. A chip meant a piece of wood. Hardwood meant hardware, and software wasn't even a word. Back then, made in Japan meant junk. The term making out referred to how did you do on your exam? Pizza, McDonald's, and Diet Coke were unheard of. We hit the scene where there were 5 and 10 cent stores where you brought things for 5 and 10 cents. For one nickel, you could ride a bus, make a phone call, or buy enough stamps to mail one letter and 2 postcards. Go to the movies and have popcorn, all for 25 cents. A song in the jukebox cost 10 cents, hamburgers 10 cents, and pop 7 cents. You could buy a new Chevy coupe for 600, but who could afford one? A pity, too, because gas was only 11 cents a gallon. Rock and roll was our movement, and Elvis Presley was our idol. In our day, grass was mowed, Coke was a cold drink, pot was something you cooked in, acid was something used in chemistry lab, and shooters were the bad guys in the Western movies. No wonder we are so confused, but we survived, and what better reason to celebrate?
Thank you. Don't you ever belch.
Don't throw spitballs.
Don't throw hands.
Don't hit your nose.
Don't pull your gums. Don't break wind. Don't hit your face.
Don't you ever belch.
Don't throw spitballs.
Don't hold hands.
Don't pick your nose.
Don't break wind.
Don't you ever belch.
Don't throw spitballs.
Don't hold pain.
Don't hit your nose. Don't hit your gum.
And don't break wind. Don't
hit your hand. Don't ever wet your
Thank you.
reflecting off it. It blew out my bulb.
Probably one of the cuter ones.
Yeah. Oh, get out of here.